Mr. Did you have pro boxing fights? Huh? Did you have ever pro boxing fights? Did you fight pro?
No, all was in the alley.
When it counts.
Yeah.
When is the last time you talked to Sylvester Stallone? It's been a minute?
It's been a while. Way back in, I seen him, it was last year. He had tweeted when I was doing Dance with the Stars.
Yeah, he asked you?
Yeah, we did Dance with the Stars last year. So he had tweeted a couple of times. He had talked about how when we finished training, we would go off and eat ice cream. You know, so, but I haven't seen him in a way. I know he was busy with Creed and stuff like that, you know. Me, I'm the type of guy, believe in giving people space. I don't cry when people hate this.
How was Dancing with the Stars?
It was great.
A lot of endurance. Sugar Ray Leonard did it. Mayweather did it.
Yeah, you know, I did, like I said, it's not the, you know, I like I told him, you know, I can't dance. It wasn't about me dancing. It was an opportunity for my fans to see me doing something else.
Yes.
Because when you say dance, you say, what, Mr. T, dance? I got to see this. So it's a fun thing.
Yeah.
So it was an opportunity for me. So I gave my money to St. Jude and Shriners. I gave half to St. Jude and half to Shriners because I'm a cancer survivor. So I'm sensitive to the less fortunate kids, the kids that don't have what I have. So it's my way of giving back. But at the same time, not grandstanding. Not saying, hey, y'all, look at me and whatever. Give it quietly. You're not crying. You're no sensitive.
I did a whole week of coverage for Shriners to help them.
That's good,
and
man.
They had a dinner and they invited me and I didn't show up. They wanted to give me an award. I didn't know. I was busy. I'm like, I don't need a dinner.
Right. Listen with me. I tell you, no, go ahead.
I like what they do because the parents don't pay. The kids
right, exactly.
Don't pay. It's amputees.
That's what I like about it. Definitely. Because I remember Danny Thomas, what he did to St. Jude, when he started, whatever, what he did. I said, wow. And I would visit the hospital. I went down there way back in the 80s. I said, man, that's special. And that's what I'm trying to give to the parents, to the whatever stuff, you know. Just help quietly, you know. It makes me feel inside. Make me feel good inside.
They're good people. The kids don't pay anything.
Yes, exactly.
And they come from all over the world.
Yep.
What's your favorite punch in boxing?
Huh?
What's your favorite punch? You like uppercut, jab?
No, I'm a southpaw. See, basically, I said bang, 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 pow! You never see it coming. I mean, you might see it coming. I ain't that fast, you know. It's slow. But if you slow it down, if you slow it down, another is here.
When you and Rocky exchange punches, do you guys go 50%, 70%, or
100%? No, we went 100%. He had told me, he said, T, if you know, because we know what we're going to do, because we got the choreography. He said, if you forget the duck, I'm going to have to pop you. He said, if I forget the duck, pop me. Because if you pull back, it'll look phony on the tape. So just go for it, you know. So nothing personal. He said, if I pop you, it's I won't be personal if you pop me. That's what it is. You want to make
it. What happened when you tape?
Then we popped you a couple of times, you know, bang, bang. And we did around, bang, 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 you know. So because after we go to the choreography for the fight, we would go two rounds raw every day after practice.
How hard does he hit?
He hit pretty good.
How hard do you hit?
I don't brag. You know, I stopped bragging after high school, you know. I'm okay. What I do, I defend myself. That's all. I'm not a brute. I'm not a predator. You know, I deal in self-defense. And self-defense is, if you attack me, I'm going to defend myself. I'm not going to attack you. I'm going to step up. Matter of fact, if you block it, if I'm walking down the street, And you blocking my way, I step around.
Mind your own business.
I step around. That's what discipline teaches me. That's what martial art teaches me. That's what my mother teaches me. Let it go, son, let it go. If they attack me,
okay.
That's a different story.
So if they let you in the movie do a fight without choreograph, who would have won, Clubber Lang or Rocky? If there was no script.
Nah, Rocky win. See how I said, see how easy.
But you beat him the first time.
Yeah, but that was a script that said that. Well, you see how easy I decreased so he could increase. I ain't gonna say, I'll rip him up. I won't do that. You know, I won't do that, you know. You know, it's a fun thing and whatever, you know. I'm not gonna go around saying in real life I'm tougher than Rocky.
No,
I don't do that. I see, I don't ego trip, you know. I'm securing myself to give him his respect, and he deserved it. He created the show, he came over, you know, he talked to me a lot about how the business is and whatever. He worked hard, he earned it. So I respect that, you know.
Huh? He made it to the Hall of Fame. He got a statue in Philly. He made it to the Hall of Fame.
Oh, yeah.
He has a statue in
Philly. Yeah, you can't beat that. That's me. I mean, it's just so inspirational. When you hear that music, dun-dun-dun-dun-dun. And I keep telling myself, I said, T, you fight this guy, you watch Rocky 1, Rocky 2. Now you fighting him. Did I a couple of scenes when we were rehearsing? He said, harder, harder. I said, damn, he don't know I've knocked guys out. And I said, if I hit him too hard, he might not give me the job. So it was a rough thing, you know. So, but I gave him enough so he can feel me, you know. So, but it was good. It was good. It was really good.
You worked with him.
Huh?
You worked with him, as they say.
Yeah, well, and plus, you know, I had told him after he picked me, and then he said, I know you will, T, I know you will. And that's what it's all about. Because my mother, go back to my mother, say, she said, son, if you work for a man, for God's sake, you be loyal to that man. Give him an honest day's work for honest day's pay.
That's it.
It's just that simple.
Right.
So I didn't come in with the big head and all that stuff. I didn't come in and say, okay, now I got it. I want a limousine to pick me up. I want a Ferrari. I want all that. Uh-uh. I said, I'm going to work hard for you. I'm not going to let you down. I'm not going to be partying on Sunset and all that stuff or whatnot. Come on, get it. You know.
So there you have it, another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter, @Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram, @Elie Seckbach.